What up, folks? Welcome back to Ultrazilla Toys, and today I have a review of this hunk of burning love here. The SH Monster Arts Ultimate Burning Godzilla. Yeah, man. This is a cool re-release here. I really dig the little bit of extra effort here on Tamashii's part to give us a re-release, kind of slight repaint, and but give us something really cool and unique that makes it stand out. And that's obviously the effects parts that are these like awesome like smoke effect parts. So it makes it reminiscent of the movie Godzilla vs. Destroyer. Like, I think that's very cool. The minute I saw that, and I'm not one for most of the recent repaints, I didn't get the special color King Ghidorah, and I'm not getting Destroyer. Those are for me, you know, they're okay, like, but I think this is a cooler thing. King Ghidorah does have that cool flight stand, so don't get me wrong, I have my eyes on like possible like sales if I ever see it, but as of now, don't have it. I don't see any reason to get Destroyer. But that's neither here or there. Here, we're talking about this guy. And this looks super cool. The new paint is the spines here. The dorsal spines are all done in that orange paint. So it kind of goes right into it. And instead of these being white, and we will look at the other, the original figure soon. And also it's done in this glossy, I would say black almost. It's not really charcoal gray anymore. It's definitely a darker color. I like it. I don't mind the glossiness. I know some folks think it looks cheap, but I'm gonna differ there. Shiny things are not necessarily cheap. I don't always prescribe to that. I think it's on a case-by-case basis, and this to me does not look cheap at all. Let's get one size comparison out of the way just to show you what cheap looks like. No offense to NECA's Burning Godzilla, but I mean, there's really no comparison here. I also recently picked this up, finally, and I'm trying to figure out where I'm going to do. I have like a bunch of NECA's that I recently picked up that I need to review, so look out for that, or listen up to my Vlogzillas, because I'm either doing it here or like a full set of them on the Repack podcast. So most likely news will come on Vlogzilla, or you'll just see the review here. We'll see. But yeah, like, so to me that does not bother me. The glossy paint, it looks really cool. And I am showing him off with these attached first and foremost, because this is what I bought it for, and this is what I want to see on it more than anything. It's not about the base figure at all. It's about this full package, and this full package does look awesome. So I really wanted to start out with everything on him first. Like, if you could tell, like, it just looks... these things are really cool. They're like translucent, and then they go into the white, you know, on every piece. Translucent into the white. Translucent into the white. And look, they look good. The sculpt on them is really nice. It looks like what it's supposed to look like, you know? He looks cool. It's done well, so... Now I can take them off, and if you want to look at them further a little bit. But yeah, very nice pieces here. And as you can see, this one will clip into his arm. You pull the joint down a little bit, and you're able to put it in. And as I did, I just pulled it up. This one up here, around his head, and neck, like, I didn't see it in the directions, but I definitely feel like the, if you look in, sorry, if you look in here, there's a little groove there, that easily connects to, I'll put it in here, and it easily connects to the dorsal fin there. The spines, whatever you want to call them. So yeah, on that one, oops, it just hit this Optimus Prime sword. Such a nice sword. On his arm here, it's connected around his elbow joint. I have it, and then it goes around his forearm. Very cool piece. And the leg, similar to the arm here, there's a little kind of little hooking piece here that you want to just stick in there and connect. This one, like out of the package, was so wide that it was really bothering me. All I have to do is just like pop it back up and you're good to go if you want to display it like this. But again, I did not get it to display like that, so it wouldn't have mattered to me anyway. So yeah, like if you haven't seen this mold, this is pretty much the, you know, the 94 mold that's been used a bunch of times, and you know, it's a good Godzilla. It's probably the definitive SH MONSTERARTS Godzilla at this point. It's the rebirth version. It's such a great piece, you know, like I really like this one. So the sculpt is really nice on it. It's always been just, this is Godzilla, you know. And we're still getting that Eva colored one soon. I'm still don't know if I'm getting that. I didn't pre-order it, I'll say that. So if I do find it, it'll, you know, it'll be on a whim. And but I know it's dropping like in the next week or so, so I will be on the lookout for the Evazilla, you know. And hopefully that's the last we see of this mold. While I like it, I think it's enough, you know. Let's move on to other things, please, MONSTERARTS. Let's get some new things going. So let's look at this guy further. Let's take a look at the head sculpt. And this has been, you know, a bone of contention here because, you know, this is has some problems. I'm gonna say mine is okay. It's not 100% perfect, but like as you can see, the eyes look good. I'm not having a real issue there at all. They're looking straight ahead. All right. Yeah, I think they look good. The mouth has been another place where we've had some problems I've seen. It's okay, it's not bad. It's not perfect, but it's not bad. You know, like up here on this side, you'll get a little more gums, but you do have all the teeth clearly defined on the top. So while I do have a little more gum there than over here, like I'm gonna say it's like more of a, let's see, like case of like more of a snarl on one side than the other. I mean, if you want to argue that that's sloppy, it's fine with me. But that doesn't 100% bother me. If anything, I feel like this side, the red comes down a little bit more, and this side is a little better. I don't know. Maybe we need more red up here. I do see some splotches of black seeping onto the red, so maybe if that was actually a little more cleaner, it would look a little better. But otherwise, it's, I mean, and the only other thing I'll say is the jaw. Like it kind of doesn't, like if you just close his mouth, like his mouth closes more than the original does, And he does sit a little, when you sit, look at him like that, he does look a little goofy, for sure. But, you know, when you open up his mouth, and you just shift it just a bit, you know, you're in a lot better, in a lot better place, honestly. And the inside of the mouth looks fine. So, I mean, especially when his mouth is completely open, it looks fine. So it's like, you know, I mean, I think it's good. The eyes are good, so that really helps. And then, the teeth, could be a tad better, but they're not, like, deal-breakingly bad. And I've seen some deal-breakingly bad ones, unfortunately. So, I think, like, you know, like I've mentioned before on my MONSTERARTS reviews, we've seen figures across the board lately, so from Shin Godzilla and GMK, you know, and the 54, there's definitely been a wide, especially with Shin Godzilla, that was like really a big bone of contention. Lots of like, you know, the full gamut, and you're seeing it here again, but I like, and you've seen a lot of it in the head sculpt. And, you know, the paint apps on the head, so, but I'm liking what I see on mine, so, again, it could be slightly better, but not deal-breakingly bad. I like it, and again, you know, the eyes look good, so, there's a plus there. I love the clear spines, they look good. Very nicely painted. You know, the gray or black, whatever it is. And then these guys, the all orange ones, look good. Clean. Right? That's pretty clean. So I dig that. I think it's, can I remove just a bit here? I think that's pretty well done. The paint on him, like, I like, again, I personally like the glossiness of it. It makes it stand out. It makes, I think part of the reasoning here is it makes all this orange really pop, and it really does. It really does, guys. I love it. I love that shiny look and how it makes the, you know, the orange pop, and I love the translucency here on the legs, and the torso. So very, very, very cool. The little black wash over it looks good. His hands look, his fingernails on his hands look good as well on his feet. So very cool. Since I just mentioned his hands, he does also come with a pair of, you know, I guess slightly more open hands. So, and they're painted well, you know. It's really slight. I don't know, yeah, let's, should we try one on? Let's try one on. Pop it there. I haven't tried these on yet, so I don't know if they're super tight. Alright, I'm getting it in there, so, alright. It's not that much of a difference. I'm not exactly sure why we have them. but they're there if you want slightly more open hands. So, pretty cool. The articulation on this guy, if you've never seen this mold, you got a lot of good points of articulation. This is a very good articulated Godzilla head. The jaw, as we saw, got a ball joint there. There's another one, another joint here, but that's pretty tight on mine, so I'm not gonna try to move it too much. The shoulders, you know, also remember they come down and out, so you wanna be able to stick the effect part in there. We got a nice elbow here. Wrists. Yep. Wrists. And again, shoulders on this Godzilla, just to look at it again, is they're kind of limited, but you know, it's not terrible. You don't really see Godzilla usually like reaching up for the sky. He's got really nice ab joints here, and if you know, like, this joint tends to pop out a lot on this mold, but I haven't had that problem yet with this particular one. But yeah, as you can see, you got ball joint up here, ball joint down there, so you get a good range of motion and not too much gap here as caused from it. That's cool. The wrists, the thighs also have a nice joint. You can really see in there on, from this angle. You see the ball in there and a ball there. So that allows you to be able to get that giant gap in here, so you could open and close it up to stick the effect part in there. The knees look good. Again, like, it's covered up really well, the joints, so you never really see the ball joint. Same thing with his elbows. I love that. I mean, I always say that about the Monstars. It's really, you know, that, the textures of these, like, that's what I really love, you know. I mean, the articulation is really great, but there's other things about Monstars that I like more than the articulation, to be completely truthful. So you got joints down here, double up here. Well, it's a good ankle movement, which have the little floaty piece above it. It's cool. And of course, awesome segmented tails. So there's a good joint right in there. Another one right there. And then this is, you know, kind of a whole piece here. So, but yeah, obviously articulation is great. Very great on this guy. So I don't know, I really love him, you know, like, paint is good. The issues that I know exist aren't so bad on mine, so please, if you liked, you know, this, I mean, I can say, if you're not paying a super amount for him, I think he's worth taking a chance on, because, you know, maybe just wait, maybe wait for a sale. You know, Amazon always has these guys on sale. You'll feel better about gambling, but I don't know if it's that much of a gamble. Like, again, I haven't seen that many reviews on it, but my review isn't that bad. You know, like, I think it looks good. So I don't mind what I see here. I mean, and I love this. This looks great. So let's bring in the original now. Now, the original I really love, but there's a lot of differences. Look at the giant paint difference here to here. There's some interesting differences with the actual paint. Actually, you just have, like, different colors. Like, there's a big thing of yellow in there. It's in there here, but it's a little more muted. My background's falling down. Tails. So you got more yellow in this, and you got almost pure orange with a little bit of hints of yellow in that one. So that's a big difference. You know? So yeah. You know, obviously this one doesn't have, like, the mouth issue that this one has, but the problem I've had with this one is I hate the white. I never liked how this looked. I don't recall in the movie it being this white, but I could be wrong. I haven't watched the movie in a long, long time, so, but, yeah, either way, on the figure, I never liked this. I wish it was just, you know, standard grayish. So this, I think, is super, super, super cool. Even if it's not right, I like this so much more. Also, I came in on this guy late, and I ended up paying aftermarket prices for this, which were not pretty. So I'll always have this thing that, you know, sometimes price is a big factor, and that's why I'm saying if you get this guy, you're going to really like it. Price always factors into these things in your enjoyment, I think, because, you know, you could let things go, you could feel better about certain things if you paid a certain amount of money. Again, I paid a lot of money for this, and I wasn't completely satisfied. So, yeah, there's that. That's part of it, you know, for sure. Here's the Comic-Con Explosion one, which is one of my absolute favorite Godzillas. So, love it. Love this one. You know, and they kind of, you can have them all on the shelf together, because it's like, you know, the various stages, you know, Ray from Muteki Cell made a good, said a good thing. If this does have bad eyes and the jaw thing, it's like kind of like he's melting down. So, you know, if you want to look at it like that, you can as well. And then, boom. Great progression here. So final thoughts here. I dig it, you know. It's, like, just like this, like I said at the top of the review, he looks awesome. This, to me, is indeed the ultimate burning version. No matter what you think, if you get a decent one with the with eyes that are okay, and a mouth that is either okay, perfect, or you can deal with, like, when you set it up like this, and honestly, the teeth aren't, to me, the bigger problem, the biggest problem is the way his jaw, sits in his mouth. That, to me, is the biggest problem, but for me personally, since I'm gonna be displaying him just like this with his mouth open, it's not a problem. It looks really good, and I just think this is a nice piece for your display. So that's my overall thoughts, guys. I think it's, for me, it was worth it. I really liked it. Again, I've had my issues with the ones that were available, the NECA and the original version, for one reason or another, and I definitely like this one the best. So your mileage may vary, and that's understandable. And I won't blame you, but I like this one. I could definitely recommend it if you could find it on a sale. So, I don't know if, like, I think it's like $85 normally. I'm not sure. Is it worth it? I don't know. Like, base, if you consider all these parts, you know, $20 worth of parts, maybe, but I would say comfortably like $65 to $70 is a better bet. So maybe wait for an Amazon deal and, you know, get them then, because I think it's definitely worth it for that price. Even $75, go for it. but yeah, I mean, if you want to get it now for $85, I'm not going to blame you either. So, and hopefully you'll get a good one. So, I'm hoping more folks get good ones than not. You know, I don't want to see unhappy people online with this or any other figure. You know, your general, you know, hopes are that a figure turns out okay, and you know, for most people, you're gonna have blips on the radar, and sometimes you're gonna have a lot of blips on the radar, but you hope for the best for most folks, and I hope for the best for you guys. So that's all I got. Give a like, if you can, you know, check out my Facebook page, Ultrazilla Toys. I will have photos up of this guy very soon, and if you could like, comment, subscribe here, that would be awesome. If you want to share this video, I'd super appreciate it. Until next time, peace out, peeps.